The LEGO Star Wars 20th anniversary sets were revealed at the German Toy Fair today. There's the $20 Imperial Dropship, $30 Anakin's Pod Racer, $30 Scout Walker, $40 Snow Speeder, and $130 Slave 1. I'm using pictures from 9to5 Toys, which had really good quality pictures, and this is a cool idea. Remaking some iconic LEGO Star Wars sets with not only updated figures, but special anniversary figures. But wow, these are overpriced. You know, the same thing LEGO Star Wars feels like nowadays. Like, this set is based off that very popular battle pack, but now it's 20. Why? Because of that recreation of the very basic Han Solo? Which I like that they're re-releasing these classic versions, which they're doing more for display than play. But because of that inclusion, the purpose of this being a battle pack is a bit farther now, since it's $20 versus $15. And even $15 wasn't a popular move by LEGO. Like, I know inflation is a thing, but this is $40. Remember when the Hoth Wampa was $40? Same with the Slave 1, which is $130. Cheaper sets from other themes have so much more content to them. And the UCS one is $70 more for so much more. This just has better figures. Another thing that stands out to me is that the mid-legs they use for Padme, that means that mid-legs are being produced in sets now, not just CMF series. Opens the gate for them appearing in other themes, and I totally called that young Anakin would come in an anniversary set. What do you guys think? Keep in mind these aren't the only Spring 2019 sets for Star Wars. Apparently they're going to have a new type of action set, some resistance sets, and even a Kylo vs. Rey, The Force Awakens set. But leave your thoughts in the comments below. I'll see you guys later. Peace out. Bye.